We got a huge challenge this week against a really good football team. I mean, it's a team that started off the season last year 7-3, and then their quarterback went out and lost the last seven games. But this is a really good football team that we're playing, and on both sides of the ball and in the kicking game. So it'll be a huge test for us opening up the season in the dome.
Yeah, I know Taysom was listed as a QB on the roster. Is there a reason that you guys changed up from
Titan? Probably more of a clerical thing than anything else. But, Taysom took, I think, about 50, almost 50% of his snaps last year at the quarterback position. So I don't know that there's anything really to that other than he kind of plays a lot of different positions.
Does that anything to do with, like, the emergency QB roles, like just how you guys might configure?
Well, I think when you look at it and you say he plays almost 50% of his snaps at the quarterback position, we just listed him there.
How much was Marshawn able to work in?
He was limited today, so we'll see where he's at on Wednesday.
Dennis, from a defensive standpoint, what's the first thing for Tennessee that you got stopped?
Well, I mean, I don't think there's any question that, this team runs a lot of their offense through the running game, particularly Derrick Henry. Obviously, with Tajay Spears being there now, they've got a couple of different runners that they can utilize. But you have to be able to stop, the run play action game and, hopefully get them into some longer yardage situations. So that'll be a big part of what we do.
Is his size, does that make how you play, where you might play a different running back a different way? Do you have to play him differently?
Well, I would say you got to get 11 guys around the ball, because I think they led the league in terms of, yards after contact in the running game. And so he's a really good back, strong, physical, has great speed. He's able to break the long ones. And then they utilize him in the screen game, too. I think that's important. They do a really good job on a lot of their play action screen game. Well, I don't know that. I mean, it'll be our first experience seeing him up live and in person. So it's probably easier to defend him when he wasn't on the field. But yeah, look, I mean, he's a dynamic back. I mean, he's one of the better backs in our league. So it'll be a challenge for us. Yeah, tough, smart, disciplined. They play a lot of close games. They don't beat themselves. They take advantage of when their opponents make mistakes. So I think they're generally one of the more physical teams that plays in our league. Yeah, I think all those things play into account. We'll have a game plan to utilize all of our, skill players, try to put our guys always in the best position to have success. And so we'll have a plan to be able to utilize him. How we utilize him may change from week to week, but certainly he'll be a big part of what we're trying to do.
You guys able to give an update on Kendrick Miller?
No. There'll be an injury report come out on Wednesday, so.
I'm assuming that you guys don't expect him to play, or that's still.
I wouldn't make any assumptions.
Do you feel like y'all have more varied weapons on offense that you can draw on this season compared to last season?
We got Mike Thomas back. Obviously, he adds an element to our offense. I think we got a couple of young receivers that are going into their second year that have a chance to take a step forward. We've got varied weapons at the tight end position, some different things that we can utilize at the running back position. I think we have more weapons offensively, and we'll try to put them in the best position to utilize them. And hopefully have some success with that.
I know Tim Kelly was there last year, but first year in the OC role. Like, when you're going against a new OC, do you have to almost be more prepared to adjust on the fly?
Yeah, look, I mean, you know, I think anytime you go into the first game of the year, you know, teams don't usually show a lot in the preseason, so it's hard to really get an evaluation of exactly what they want to do. I think there's probably some core principles that will remain the same. I don't expect to see, you know, a totally different offense, but yeah, we'll have to be able to adjust to whatever they're doing and kind of get a feel for how he's going to call the game.
How much better do you think you are offensively?
Well, I think we'll find out. You know, I feel confident in where we're at offensively. I like what I've seen all throughout training camp and in the preseason. So I think we're in a good spot.
Guys, do you – I know it's goofy and I'm sorry. Do you feel any different at this point this year than last year? Is there a level of comfort that you can maybe detect in yourself that you feel a little bit more comfortable in the role this year than last year or not?
Look, I mean – I get asked that question a lot. I would just say I'm confident in our football team. I think we've had a really good camp. I think we've executed at a high level, really, in all three phases throughout training camp. And so I feel confident in what this team's able to do.
Is getting off to, like, you just referenced the team that got off to a good start and then dealt with some issues last year.
Yeah.
I know that most of the success here, maybe in 17, it was always a good start.
You know, a lot of times people talk about must-win games and things of that nature, and so I would never say that this is a must-win game. You know, I think getting off to a good start is important, but yet it's not the end-all, be-all in terms of where you finish the season. I think anytime you get a chance to start off fast and you know, hopefully stack some wins together early on in the season. When you know you're going to face some adversity, you know you're going to face some injury issues as the season wears on, banking a few wins is always good.
You never quite know, we saw that last night, how openers are going to go. As a coach, is there a little more added concern when you, I know you had preseason games, but when it starts and you're not totally sure what you're going to get?
Well, I don't think that's unique to any other season. You know, you got to start the season at some point. And so, we'll start this thing on Sunday and go out against a really good team. And we'll have a good game plan. We'll play well in this game. And, we'll see how it goes.
What do you have to watch for with Jeffrey Simmons on the Tiger defense?
He's a big, powerful guy inside. They got a lot of good guys up front. They were number one in the league last year in stopping the run. You know, so that presents a challenge. They probably do as good a job or as most in terms of just being able to get pressure on the quarterback with a four-man rush. It hadn't been a heavy pressure team. So I think the line of scrimmage in this game, really on both sides of the ball, is going to be a big factor.
So speaking of that, it looks like the Titans have some personnel changes on the offensive line.
Yeah.
What did you see them trying, at least trying to accomplish? How do you expect those changes to?
Yeah, I don't expect a lot different in terms of what they do, in terms of the core philosophy of who they are offensively. Obviously, we expect probably to see four new starters, and then the fifth, was moving from center to guard. So, in essence, they got five new guys, playing in different spots on their offensive line. So, but I don't expect a whole lot different in terms of the way they approach the game.
In concert with that, you've got some changeover on the defensive line, particularly on the interior. How do you feel that matches up for you?
Yeah, look, I feel good about the matchups. Like I said before, I mean, I think, the team that controls the line of scrimmage is probably going to have a pretty good chance of success in this game. And so I think that's going to be a big factor.